Eric Trump said his father, President Donald Trump, saw his life became exponentially worse the minute he decided to run for president. The presidential son also argued his half-siblings, 12-year-old Barron and 24-year-old Tiffany, should be 100% off-limits to the mockery and media attention the rest of the Trump offspring face. The first son and his wife Laura talked to Westchester magazine about their life in upstate New York and being a part of the extended first family. The piece is filled with glamorous photos of the two with their son Luke and their dogs, Charlie and Ben, at their home, that was formerly owned by Washington Post publisher Eugene Meyer, and at the Trump National Golf Club in Briarcliff Manor. There would be far fewer headaches if it weren't for politics, Eric Trump told the magazine but added it's all worth it when you know you're in it for the right reasons. My father's life became exponentially worse the minute he decided to run for president. He didn't need to do this, but he was immensely frustrated with where the country was going, Eric noted. The 34-year-old also noted the intense media spotlight that came with Donald Trump's decision to run for the White House. Every day, you get abused by somebody, he says, referring to certain segments of the media, and the next thing you know, you're being parroted on Saturday Night Live. It comes with the territory. We stood center stage with my father during the campaign and beyond. In March, Saturday Night Live featured a skit in which Eric, played by Alex Moffat, was portrayed as an imbecile next to Mikey Day's Don Jr., who was shown as more on the ball. Eric Trump agrees himself and siblings Ivanka and Donald Jr. are fair game to the public scrutiny, but he feels different about the younger Trumps, 12-year-old Barron, whose mom is First Lady Melania Trump, and 24-year-old Tiffany, whose mom is Marla Maples. We are adults, we've developed a bit of an armor, he says, but Barron and Tiffany should be 100% off limits. Tiffany Trump has an active Instagram account that includes photos of her at the White House and is a student at Georgetown University. She has become a regular at New York's Fashion Week and was spotted at events around the in-crowd occasion for the past couple of years, both in February 2018 and September and February 2017, attending parties thrown by glossy magazines and sitting in the front row of fashion shows, such as Dowry Wong's Spring 2018 show. She caused a stir in September when her representative emailed Harper's Magazine about Tiffany attending a Fashion Week party that was being thrown by Harper Bazaar magazine. It was reported she attended a Playboy party this past New Year's Eve. Barron is a student at the private St. Andrew's Episcopal School in Potomac, Maryland. He is rarely seen in public and usually only at official events when his mother is present. Laura Trump also admitted there are times when some of her family members pine for the old days. Eric and Laura Trump were a forceful presence for Donald Trump's campaign during the 2016 election. Laura Trump became an especially popular presence, recording videos for the campaign and is actively working on Trump's re-election effort. The two met in New York and dated for 10 years before they were married at Mar-a-Lago in November 2014. The couple said Westchester is a sanctuary for them and remembered the days before the election when they flew under the radar within the county. Eric Trump said any upheaval that resulted from his father's election came at a perfect turning point when he could focus on his job with the Trump Organization and being with his nuclear family. Eric Trump serves as executive vice president of the Trump Organization and isn't spotted at the White House often. It's important to keep separation of church and state, Eric Trump told ABC News after the election. President Trump saw his net worth drop by $100 million over the last year to $2.8 billion as revenue at his namesake Trump Towers and golf courses fell, Bloomberg News reported last week. Eric Trump, in the meantime, has avoided a lot of the scandal that has engulfed the rest of the Trump family. It was Donald Jr. who was cited as being in meetings with Russians at Trump Tower during the election. And it was Don Jr. who then tweeted out emails in November 2017 intended to preempt a New York Times expose on his talks with WikiLeaks but which only raised more suspicions. In a May 2016 Washington Post profile of Eric and his siblings who are the children of Trump's first wife, Ivanka Trump, he credited time as a youngster in the Czech countryside with his maternal grandparents as part of the reason for his grounded life. He also attended boarding school in Pennsylvania and graduated from Georgetown University. "I'd like to apologize to Eric Trump," Stephen Colbert said on his late-night show last July. "We always thought you were the dumb one. We were wrong.